कॉफी पे चर्चा विद मी रिजवान असद आई हैव विद मी बापू नारायण कर अ सीनियर जर्नलिस्ट विल बी स्पीकिंग ऑन द स्टेट पॉलिटिक्स सर यू हैव बीन इन द फील्ड ऑफ जर्नलिज्म फॉर मोर देन 20-25 इयर्स हाउ डू यू सी द स्टेट पॉलिटिक्स अंडर येडियुरप्पा हियर एंड व्हाट डू यू फोरसी
Be specific, what is the question?
I'm asking you, now that government is informed and there's going to be a cabinet expansion
okay.
and he's under tremendous pressure to make the dissident JDS and Congress MLAs who shifted out to BJP and who are MLAs in the BJP now to allot them a cabinet berth. Do you think that by giving them the cabinet berth, dissidents will be on the rise in the BJP?
I would like to thank for inviting me coffee pe charcha. It's a nice concept which you have initiated. As far as your question goes, I don't see any headache for Yediyurappa because there are 16 vacancies out of which six will be given to the dissident MLAs which from other parties which they have joined the BJP and two will be given to the BJP MLAs. So right now I don't think that there will be a problem for the Yediyurappa government because Yediyurappa and also the BJP sources tell me that the next round of expansion also is going to happen and they would like to pacify some of the dissident MLAs which have joined from other parties to BJP. So right now I reiterate that there is no such problem for this government.
So you only think three or four MLAs and another three will take place and again you'll have expansion again for the second time?
Yes, that's how it has been. Even if you see the long history, whenever such things develop in Karnataka politics, we have been seeing the last government also we have seen that expansion takes place in phase wise. This is a strategy to pacify some
and keep in check
the dissident activities. So this is a strategy adopted by all the political parties. So right now I don't feel any problem being faced by Yediyurappa government.
Congress, there is a saying that if D.K. Shivakumar becomes a president of Congress, many from the BJP will join him. How do you see that?
I don't think it's quite laughable because when you see the decline of Congress in Karnataka especially, I would like to bring to your notice the history of the declination of Congress in all the states. Let us begin with Kerala, then Bihar, then Uttar Pradesh, then Haryana, Rajasthan. Of course, it's sometimes Congress and BJP. But if you see Gujarat and all these states which I'm mentioning, whenever the party's vote share percentage has fallen below 20%, let it be that Bihar, UP, Congress has never come back to the state politics. Even that happened, we have seen during the last elections also. The Congress, which had 122 seats, if I am right, they were reduced to some 75 or 78, let me complete, 78 seats. So what I mean to say is whenever their voting percentage has dipped in Lok Sabha elections, they have not come back to power. So knowing all these factors, I don't see any big leaders of the stature of Yediyurappa, not Yediyurappa, joining Congress for now.
So the threat of Yediyurappa being changed also. There's a talk because age factor, because and he's only a tallest leader in the BJP and in the Lingayat community. Do you think BJP won't make a mistake of replacing him? Or
no.
Is there saying, there's some say that he may be replaced after the budget?
No, I would really agree to that, whatever you're saying, that I clearly foresee that there will be a change of leadership down the line. I don't know when, what time. But let me be very, very clear that there will be a leadership change because he's already more than 75.
77.
And his exit will be very, very normal. And I believe that all the central leadership must have also been giving hints to Yediyurappa that at one point of time they are going to change because they have to look for the new faces in the future. So these are the things, you know, which I feel that down the line Yediyurappa is going to be changed.
Because
now the aspirations of the youth and the people of this country is very big. Of course, Yediyurappa is known for his struggles for farmers' concerns and problems. But if you see the recent chief ministers of BJP in various other states, they are all young. So Yediyurappa does not fall under the category of taking forward the technological development, the infrastructural development, because Yediyurappa has not been ever seen as a leader, an all-round leader, but a farmer's leader. So I feel that keeping in view the aspirations of the youth, BJP is clearly thinking of changing the guard.
So don't you think it will become a big mistake if Yediyurappa has changed? Because last time when Yediyurappa was not there in BJP, BJP was damaged and Congress came to power. Being the tallest leader from his community and being a very tall leader in the BJP, do you think that they BJP will take a chance and see that the government falls? Because after that, you know, who are the second line leadership? Who are claiming to be the chief minister? And you know, there is no, according to sources, that there are a lot of aspirants are there. So do you think that there will be a big mistake by changing it?
I will tell you the fact. There will be no mistake. The central leadership will take into confidence Yediyurappa. They will have a meeting with him, sit with him and tell, look, we are looking for a change of guard. And they will give free hand to Yediyurappa. They are going to give free hand to Yediyurappa to choose his leader.
So his sons will be accommodated in the cabinet?
For your kind information, BJP doesn't believe in that, because we have seen while the distribution of the Mysore the Lok Sabha elections in the Mysore constituency, Yediyurappa's son was not given the ticket. So there is a big history behind of BJP that they don't do politics of dynastic politics, if I may be correct.
Coming to the budget, what type of budget he'll give? Good budget or a farmer's budget?
Then let us see what Yediyurappa will give. I cannot, just imagine.
So coming to national politics, now all eyes are on the Delhi election, assembly election. How do you see, Aam Aadmi Party and the BJP and the Congress fighting it out there? Because according to reports, Aam Aadmi Party is, on the high and they may get at least 55 to 60 seats. Mm. So what's your take on that?
I will be very much frank here. I have been reading in all social media platforms, and many are also tweeting that the AAP is going to
sweep
the elections. Of course, that was very much true until couple of days back. It was very, very clear that Arvind Kejriwal is going to return back to the power. But some of the developments which has happened, for example, Shaheen Bagh, he was the one, when Shaheen Bagh protest happened, he boasted, he beat his chest. I'm talking of Arvind Kejriwal. He beat his chest, and even the Congress also, they came forward and said that we are behind Shaheen Bagh protest. And the Congress leaders and also the AAP leaders are also, they have realized that the Shaheen Bagh protest support which they were giving is backfiring. Why I'm saying that?
Shaheen Bagh protest is a people's protest. What development work Aam Aadmi Party has done in terms of water, electricity, education, clinics, and giving free metro services, you know, to the aged and to the women. Do you think that won't play an important role?
No, but let me complete what you try to stop me is that after this link was established.
Let me establish.
It has not been proved, but the those parties which was behind, they were supporting Shaheen Bagh protest, they have realized. Why? I'll tell you how they have realized. Because there was a statement given by Arvind Kejriwal coaxing the BJP's Amit Shah to remove Shaheen Bagh protest. Earlier he was saying that I am behind the protest. So why is he now saying that BJP should be removed? Shaheen Bagh protest should be removed. So what I am saying is they have realized that this is not fetching them votes.
So how many seats would you give to the Aam Aadmi Party out of 70?
It's very difficult for Aam Aadmi Party. If you consider the previous elections, the Purvanchalis are the majority population living there in Delhi. The second largest population is the Punjabis, and the third largest population also is the lower income groups. So this and the Muslim groups. But what has happened to Congress and AAP is that due to the support given to anti-CAA protests, they have realized. That's what in the previous question you asked me and I answered. They have realized the mistake and it is backfiring. So they have realized that the majority of the Hindu votes will be going to BJP. Now what is left is the Muslim votes. So they have realized, the AAP and Congress have realized that there will be a very big competition among themselves to win the Muslim votes. So the Muslim votes are splitting. Last time, if you see Purvanchalis, the lower income groups and the Punjabis have voted
for Aam Aadmi.
But this time, I'll tell you, there'll be big split between all these sections of the society, because the strengthening of JDU and BJP, which they were expecting that it will fall apart, this strengthening of JDU and BJP will play a very vital role in wooing the votes of the Purvanchalis.
Yeah, yeah. No,
and
no,
second,
no, no. So
why I'm saying this, because for the first time in the history of BJP and JDU, that Amit Shah and Nitish Kumar are going to come on one stage and conduct rallies in Delhi. Secondly, about Punjab voters also. People were just thinking, the rival parties were just thinking that even the Akali Dal and BJP's tie-up will fall apart. But that also has their dreams have been shattered, and they are going to come together and rally together. So, and as far as lower income group votes are concerned, that also is going to split, because 40 lakh family of 40 unauthorized colonies were authorized by Modi. So there'll be a lot of split this time.
No, that's correct. So you mean to say that what Arvind Kejriwal has done as a chief minister, giving free electricity, free water, education, mohalla, metro, everything would won't play a very significant role. You mean to say that the votes would be split and BJP would be in the upper hand? So, thanks for speaking, Mr. Bapu, to us. Thanks for speaking. According to Mr. Bapu, a senior journalist, he says that Yediyurappa will be changed in a few days from now because BJP is looking at younger chief minister, as the trend has been in all other states, and Yediyurappa will be pacified. And you know, senior leaders also are speaking to him to see that his replacement is of his choice. He also says that BJP would come to power in Delhi, and Aam Aadmi doesn't have any that much significance after some incident which has taken place in Delhi. Rizwan Asad for Nashaman News, Bangalore.